Good morning, all of you. In last lecture, we have solved numericals on how to find out principal stress, maximum shear stress, and principal plane. Okay, so today we will continue numericals on same point. Okay, so please write down. A solid shaft. Next example, please write down. A solid shaft is subjected to a bending moment of 2.3 kilonewton meter, 2.3 kilonewton meter, and twisting moment of 3.45 kilonewton meter, 3.45 kilonewton meter. Full stop. Find the diameter of the shaft. Find the diameter of shaft. Find the diameter of shaft. If the permissible tensile and shear stress are not to exceed 703 and 241.8 and 241.8 Newton per mm square respectively. Okay, so this is the question. So in this problem, we have to find out the diameter of shaft, and here permissible stresses are given, permissible tensile stress and permissible shear stress is given. So from this permissible stress, we have to find out diameter of shaft. Okay, so first we will write which parameters are given and then we will solve problem. So in that first, which parameters are given? First we will write. A solid shaft is subjected to a bending moment. So the value of M is given. So M, which is equal to 2.3 kilonewton meter. We will convert into newton mm. So M, which is equal to. Now you tell me how to convert this 2.3 kilonewton meter to newton mm.
10 raised to 6.
2.3 into 10 raised to 6 newton mm. Okay. So kilonewton to newton is 10 raised to 3 into meter to mm is 10 raised to 3. So 3 plus 3, that is 6. So 10 raised to 6. Okay. So this is the conversion. After that, next, twisting moment. That means T is given. So T, which is equal to 3.45, same kilonewton meter. Again, you have to convert into newton mm. So T, which is equal to 3.45 into 10 raised to 6 newton mm. Okay, then next, find the diameter of shaft. So we have to find diameter. If the permissible tensile and shear stresses, permissible tensile and shear stress is given. So sigma, which is equal to, okay, sigma should not be less than, because of here are not to exceed 703. So sigma should be less than 703 Newton per mm square. Newton per mm square. And shear stress, so shear stress tau, which is equal to tau, should be less than 241.8 Newton per mm square. So these are the parameters are given. Then next, step number two, to find. So we have to find out diameter, which is equal to question mark. So D, which is equal to question mark. So this is the problem. Now we will solve step by step. So step number three. First we will apply tensile stress formula. Okay, first we will apply tensile stress formula. Okay, so sigma 1 which is equal to 16 divided by pi d cube in bracket m plus square root of m square plus t square. Okay, m square plus t square. First we will find out diameter by using tensile stress formula. Okay, so here major principal stress formula is sigma 1, which is equal to 16 divided by pi d cube. So the value of sigma 1, that is tensile stress, is given. So we will put here 703, which is equal to 16 divided by pi into d, we will put as it is in bracket. The value of m is given. So value of m is 2.3 into 10 raised to 6 plus square root of 2.3 into 10 raised to 6 plus 3.45 into 10 raised to 6. Okay, so now we will take this, from this 10 raised to 3 common, or you can solve as it is. So here 10 raised to 6 is there. Okay, so we will take common. 703, which is equal to 16 into 10 raised to 6 divided by pi d cube in bracket. So what is remaining? 2.3 plus square root of 2.3 plus 3.45. Okay. Now we will yes.
Square root madle the square karayche rahe.
Yes. Okay, so here also, (2.3)² + (3.45)². Okay, now we will shift this d cube to left side. So d cube, which is equal to 16 into 10 raised to 6 divided by pi into 703 in bracket 2.3 plus square root of 2.3² + (3.45)². Now you solve and tell me d, which is equal to how much. You calculate and give me the answer. D, which is equal to how much?
36.01.
Okay, good. Correct answer. D, which is equal to, okay, here we will write D cube, which is equal to, I think, 4601.51 mm. Okay. And after that, you press on your calculator shift and then square root. So automatically you get third root. So therefore, D, which is equal to 36.01 mm. So that much diameter we have to got by permissible tensile stress. Now we will check by applying shear stress. Okay. Now we will check by shear stress. So shear stress formula. Shear stress. We will apply shear stress formula. So shear stress formula, tau, which is equal to, or tau max, which is equal to, tau max, which is equal to 16 divided by pi d cube in bracket square root of m square plus t square. Okay, now we will put values here. So tau max value is given, that is 241.8, which is equal to 16 divided by pi d cube, will put as it is because of we have to find out this. So in bracket square root of m square, that is 2.3 into 10 raised to 6 bracket square plus t 3.45 into 10 raised to 6 bracket square. Now we will take 10 raised to 6 common and then we will solve. So 241.8, which is equal to 16 into 10 raised to 6 divided by pi d cube in bracket square root of 2.3 square plus 3.45 square. Okay. Now, same procedure, we will shift this d cube to left side and 241.8 to right side. Therefore, d cube, which is equal to 16 into 10 raised to 6 divided by pi into 241.8 into square root of 2.3 square plus 3.45 square. Now, you solve this. Therefore, d cube, which is equal to how much, and then d, which is equal to how much.
Forty-four point thirty-six.
Anyone got any other answer? Yes, 44.36. Okay. So d cube, which is equal to how much?
87332.22.
87332.22. Then d, which is equal to 44.36. 36 mm. Okay. Now here we have got two diameters. So first from tensile stress and second one from shear stress. Now we have to choose one diameter. Okay. So whenever we will choose the dimensions, of the particular member. At that time, you have to remember diameter. We will choose maximum. Diameter we will choose maximum. And whenever we have to select load, at that time, the load we will take as a minimum. Okay, load we will consider as a minimum. Therefore, diameter of shaft, which is equal to maximum of above two values, which is equal to. So, we have to got maximum value by applying shear stress formula. So, diameter which is equal to 44.36 mm. So, this is our final answer. Okay. So, from that you have to remember whenever we will choose the dimensions of the particular member, at that time we have to choose maximum dimension. And whenever we will select load, at that time we have to choose minimum load. Okay. So, according to this, the diameter of shaft for this particular question, so diameter which is equal to 44.36 mm. This is the answer. Anybody having any doubt? If no doubt, please write down fast. Then we will move towards next point. Write fast. Let me know after your writing is over. Over. Yes, completed or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so please write down next point. So next point, we will see equivalent moment. So how to find out equivalent moment and equivalent torque. So write down heading equivalent moment. So you write down first sentence, then we will continue. When bending moment of M bending moment of M and torque of T is applied on a shaft. The equivalent bending moment produced is ME. Now we will derive equation. So already we know that we know sigma 1 which is equal to, okay, sigma 1 which is equal to 16 divided by pi d cube in bracket m plus square root of m square plus t square. Okay, already we have studied this formula. This formula is for finding out major principal stress, sigma 1, which is equal to 16 divided by pi d cube in bracket m plus square root of m square plus t square. Okay, now we will see sigma, which is equal to, that is bending stress, which is equal to sigma b, which is equal to, how to find out bending stress? My divided by I. And in that, here I which is equal to pi d raised to 4 upon 64 because of shaft is circular. Okay, shaft is circular. And for circular shaft, moment of inertia which is equal to pi d raised to 4 upon 64. And we have to find out the stress at extreme fiber. So y which is equal to diameter by 2. Okay, then next y which is equal to d by 2. So this is the value of y and this is the value of I. Okay, then we will put m which is equal to me. m which is equal to me in above equation. So already our equation is sigma which is equal to, now here in this equation we will put m which is equal to me into y. Y value of y is d by 2 divided by I. Value of I is pi d raised to 4 upon 64. Okay, so now we will rearrange this equation. So sigma which is equal to me into d by 2. Okay, so this 64 shifts at numerator. Okay, so here 64 and whole divided by so here D into this 64 shift at numerator here divided by 2 into pi D raised to 4. So D and 1D gets cancelled. 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 32. So sigma which is equal to 32 ME divided by pi D cube. 32 ME divided by pi D cube. Now we will put the value of sigma. Okay. We will put the value of here ME. So ME which is equal to ME which is equal to ME which is equal to 16 divided by pi d cube in bracket m plus square root of m square plus t square, okay, which is equal to 32 ME divided by pi d cube. So this pi d cube and this pi d cube gets cancelled. What is remaining here? 16 in bracket m plus square root of m square plus t square, which is equal to 32 ME. Okay, now we will shift this 32 left side. So our final equation is 16 divided by 32 and in bracket m plus square root of m square plus t square, which is equal to m. Okay, which is equal to m. So 16 ones are 16, 16 twos are 32. Therefore, ME which is equal to 1 by 2 in bracket m plus square root of m square plus t square. So this is the formula for finding out equivalent moment. This is the formula for finding out equivalent moment. Once again, I will repeat within 2 minutes. So here we have to find out equivalent moment. Suppose this is our circular shaft. On that shaft, bending moment and torque. Bending moment and torque is applied simultaneously. And due to this bending moment and torque, the equivalent bending moment is produced. And it is denoted by ME. Okay. So already we know that sigma 1, which is equal to 16 divided by pi d cube in bracket m plus square root of m square plus t square. Now we will put here bending stress, which is equal to how to calculate bending stress. Sigma B, which is equal to MY in divided by I. So here I, moment of inertia for circular shaft, okay. Pi D raised to 4 divided by 64. And we have to find out stress at extreme fiber, So this is the diameter and we have to find out stress at this location. So this is y, okay, y which is equal to diameter divided by 2, and then we will put m which is equal to ME in above equation. Okay, so here sigma which is equal to m means ME into y is d by 2 divided by I is pi by 64 d raised to 4. After that we have rearranged this equation because of this 64 transpose to numerator. So sigma which is equal to ME into D into 64 divided by 2 into pi into D raised to 4. Here 1D and 1D gets cancelled. 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4. Okay. So from that sigma which is equal to what is remaining? 32 ME divided by pi D cube. After that here sigma 1 value is put. Okay. After that next here put sigma 1 value. Put sigma 1 value. Sigma 1 value. So value of sigma 1 is 16 divided by pi d cube in bracket m plus square root of m square plus t square, which is equal to 32 me divided by pi d cube. So here pi d cube and pi d cube gets cancelled. What is remaining? 16 m plus square root of m square plus t square, which is equal to 32 me. After that, I have shifted this 32 to left side. So 16, 1 is 16, 16, 2 is 32, and remaining terms are same. So me, which is equal to 1 half m plus square root of m square plus t square. Okay, so this is the formula for finding out equivalent moment. Okay, you have written simultaneously or you want time for writing? Yes. Have you written?
No, ma'am.
Okay, please write down fast. Let me know after your writing is over. Okay, write down next heading, equivalent torque. Okay, now we have derived equation for equivalent moment. Same way, we will derive equation for equivalent torque. So write down next, equivalent torque. Equivalent torque, okay. So here also we will consider circular shaft. Okay. So when bending moment, when bending moment M and torque T is applied is applied torque. T is applied. Torque T is applied on a shaft. On a shaft. On a shaft. The equivalent torque. The equivalent. The equivalent torque. Equivalent torque. TE is given by. TE is given by. So same way here moment and torque is applied, and due to this we have to find out equivalent torque. Okay. So already we know that. Tau max, which is equal to tau max formula. Already we know that tau max, which is equal to 16 divided by pi d cube in bracket square root of m square plus t square. Okay, so this is formula already we have derived. So tau max, which is equal to 16 divided by pi d cube in bracket m square plus t square square root of. So this is our equation one. Okay, now one equation already you know. So how to find out torque? Okay. Equation for torque. So T, which is equal to TR, torque, or tau, which is equal to, how to find out torque or shear stress?
T is equal to
tau or T, which is equal to TR divided by J. Okay, here tau or T, which is equal to TR divided by J. So here T means torque and R means diameter by 2. This is the location of stress, and J is the polar moment of inertia. So already you know that R, which is equal to D by 2, and J, which is equal to polar moment of inertia. So polar moment of inertia for circular shaft is pi d raised to 4 upon 32. Okay, pi d raised to 4 upon 32, and we will put T, which is equal to TE. Okay, so therefore T, which is equal to, or tau, which is equal to, tau, which is equal to T means TE into R. The value of R is D by 2 and whole divided by pi D raised to 4 upon 32. Okay, now 2 ones are 2, 2 ones are 2, 2 sixes are 16. 2 6 are 12. So D and 1D gets cancelled. So what is remaining? Therefore, tau, which is equal to TE. This 16 shift to numerator. So 16 TE divided by pi D cube. So that much remaining. Okay. So therefore, tau, which is equal to 16 TE divided by pi D cube. So this is our equation 2. Okay, this is our equation 2. Now we will equate equation 1 and 2. We will equate equation 1 and 2. Okay, 1 and 2. You observe in equation 1, here tau max is there and here also tau. So this tau tau we will eliminate and we will equate this. So 16 TE divided by pi D cube, which is equal to 16 divided by pi D cube in bracket square root of m square plus t square. M square plus t square. Okay. So this pi D cube and this pi D cube gets cancelled. Here 16 and 16 gets cancelled. So what is remaining? TE which is equal to square root of m square plus t square. M square plus t square. So this is the formula. This is the formula for finding out equivalent torque. Got it? You have any doubt? Please write down fast. Then we will solve numericals on this equivalent moment and equivalent torque. Okay, if your writing is all, shall we move towards next point? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now we will solve numerical on this equivalent moment and torque, because of these are the very simple formulas, but definitely one MCQ will be asked on this equivalent moment and equivalent torque. Okay, some formula is given and from that you have to choose the correct formula for finding out equivalent moment or maybe equivalent torque. So this derivation is not important, but this formula is too much important for you. Okay, so please remember this formula and this formula also. If you have forgotten this derivation, then no problem. But don't forget this formula, because of one MCQ will be asked on this equivalent torque and equivalent moment equation. So I request all of you, please remember at least formulas. Okay. Now we will take one numerical on this equivalent moment and equivalent torque. So write down example. A member is subjected to bending moment 400 newton meter and torque of 300 newton meter. Full stop. What respectively are the equivalent bending moment and equivalent torque. Okay, so here bending moment M and torque T is given, and from that we have to find out equivalent bending moment and equivalent torque. So we will solve. So this is solution. In that, first we will write given parameters. So in given, two parameters are given. Okay, so which two parameters are given? M. So M, which is equal to 400 newton meter, and T is given, T which is equal to 300 newton meter. Okay, so that much two parameters are required and both are given. After that, second step, to find what we have to find out in this question.
ME and T
equivalent moment ME, which is equal to question mark, and equivalent torque T, which is equal to question mark. Then we will apply first step, that is find equivalent moment. So equivalent moment ME, which is equal to equivalent moment ME, which is equal to equivalent moment ME, which is equal to, so equation of ME is 1/2 M plus square root of M square plus T square. m square plus t square. Therefore, m e which is equal to 1/2 in bracket. The value of m is 400 plus square root of 400 square plus 300 square. Now you solve and give me the answer. M e which is equal to how much?
450 newton.
Okay, so m e which is equal to 450 newton meter. Okay, this is the equivalent moment. This is our first answer. Then next step, we will find out equivalent torque. Okay, so find equivalent torque. So equivalent torque is denoted by TE. So TE which is equal to how to find out equivalent torque? TE which is equal to square root of m square plus t square. Square root of m square plus t square. Okay. So therefore, TE which is equal to square root of m is 400 square plus t is 300 square. Okay. Therefore, TE which is equal to how much? 500 newton meter. So this is the equivalent torque. This is the simple problem. But in your examination, so m and t value is given, and from that you have to find out TE for this MCQ also. Okay, because of only you have to required 1 minute. When m and t is given, you have to put the values in equation and you have to find out. So small problems will be asked in your university examination. Okay, so please write down. Then we will move towards last point of this unit. Write down fast and let me know after your writing is over. Okay, so we will take next point because of this is the very simple type. So we will stop numericals on that particular case. So write down last point. Combined of bending, torsion and thrust. Okay, up till now we have studied a combined of bending and torsion. That means combined of bending and shear effect. Now we will see what is the combined effect of bending, torsion and thrust. So this is the last point of unit number 3. So write down. Next is combined bending, torsion, and thrust. Torsion and thrust. Okay. So, due to this bending, or due to moment, bending stress will be generated. Due to torsion, shear stress will be generated. and due to axial, or this thrust means axial, and due to this axial force, simple stress will be generated. Okay, so now we will check what is the combined effect. Okay, so first we will see what is the bending effect. So bending moment will be given. Bending moment will be given. So this bending moment will be given by which equation? Bending stress formula. So sigma b, which is equal to sigma b, which is equal to sigma b, which is equal to
my divided by i.
So due to moment, this bending stress will be generated. Then we will see due to torque. Okay, torque will produce. Due to torque, which type of stress will be generated?
Shear stress.
Okay, good. Torque will produce shear stress. And shear stress is denoted by tau. So tau which is equal to TR divided by J. So due to torque, shear stress will be generated, and shear stress, which is equal to TR divided by J. In this, T means torque, R means location of shear stress, and J is the polar moment of inertia. Now we will see due to this thrust, which type of stress will be generated. Okay, so thrust will produce. Thrust means axial strain, axial force, or axial load. So thrust will produce normal stress. And already you know that normal stress, sigma A, which is equal to, or sigma, which is equal to, what is the formula for normal stress?
Right.
Force upon area. So you observe here, due to bending, or due to movement, bending stress will be generated. And due to thrust, normal stress will be generated. And due to torque, shear stress will be generated. So we will take addition of this bending stress. Okay, addition of bending stress. Therefore, sigma, which is equal to sigma B plus sigma A. Okay. And sigma B is my by I, and A is P by A. Okay. So this is the stress along X direction. Okay. And sigma Y, which is equal to zero here. And tau, we have calculated tau, which is equal to TR divided by J. Okay. So here sigma x, which is equal to sigma b plus sigma a, sigma y is zero, and tau, which is equal to tr by j. So from this, we will derive principal stress equation. So principal stress equation is sigma 1, sigma 2, which is equal to sigma by 2 plus minus square root of sigma by 2 square plus tau square. So this is the principal stress equation. Whenever you find sigma 1, you take this plus sign, and whenever you find out this sigma 2, you take this minus sign. So this is the formula for finding out principal stress in combined the effect of bending, torsion, and thrust. Okay. Then we will find out principal plane. Okay. Principal plane. So principal plane, which is equal to tan 2 theta, our basic equation. Tan 2 theta, which is equal to 2 tau divided by sigma. okay, 2 tau divided by sigma. So this is the equation for finding out principal plane. Okay, got it? Now we will solve numericals on this particular case. Just you have to remember this equation and this equation. But how this equation comes, that's why this basic I have studied it to you. So due to bending, bending stress will be generated. Due to torque, shear stress will be generated. And due to thrust, normal stress will be generated. After that, we have taken addition of bending stress and normal stress. So sigma x, which is equal to sigma b upon, sigma b plus sigma a. And sigma y is zero here. And tau, which is equal to tr by j. Because of our original formula is sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus square root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 bracket square plus tau square. But here sigma y is 0. That's why I have cancelled. And what is remaining? Sigma by 2 plus minus. That is this plus minus for major and minor. And again here sigma y cancelled. So sigma by 2 plus tau square. Okay. So please write down. Then we will solve numericals. Write fast. If your writing is over, we will solve numerical.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now we will take numericals on this combined bending, torsion, and thrust case. So please write down numerical. A solid circular shaft. A solid circular shaft. Solid circular shaft. Solid circular shaft is supported on bearings. Is supported on supported on bearings. Supported on bearings. in a park bearings 1 meter apart. Bearings 1 meter apart. Bearings 1 meter apart. 1 meter apart. Full stop. The shaft transmits. The shaft transmits. The shaft transmits 500 kilowatt power. 500 kilowatt power. Shaft transmits 500 kilowatt power at 300 RPM revolution per minutes by belt drive located at the middle of the shaft. Full stop. The belt exerts a total pull of 5 kilonewton. Full stop. If permissible shear stress is 50 newton per mm square. 50 newton per mm square. Full stop. Find the diameter of the shaft. Find the diameter of the shaft. So this is the question. Find the diameter of the shaft. Okay. So I will draw figure and then we will solve problem. Okay. So here one shaft is given and this is fixed at bearings here, these are the two bearings and one intermediate pulley. So suppose this is the pulley and total pull is 5 kilonewton and the total length of the shaft is 1 meter. So this is 0.5 meter and this is 0.5 meter. Okay, this is 0.5 meter. Now you tell me this 5 kilonewton load, how to transfer this A point and B point? How much load will be transferred at A point and how much load will be transferred at B point? Anyone? Out of this 5 kilonewton, how much load will take at A point and how much load will take B point?
0.5 at L.
Okay, so this is total 5 kilonewton load. Okay, so this 5 kilonewton is divided in two parts. So A will be taken 2.5 kilonewton and B will be taken 2.5 kilonewton. Got it? Or we will find out reaction. Suppose this is RA and this is RB. This is RB. So you calculate reaction and give me the answer. RA which is equal to how much and RB which is equal to how much. So how to calculate reaction, already you know that. Okay, simple. This is simply supported beam. Okay, suppose on that beam 5 kN load is applied. So A point will be take half of this 5 kN. So 5/2, and here also 5/2. So 5/2 is 2.5 kN, and here also 2.5 kN. Okay, so these are the reactions. Okay, so that much part load will be carried by point A and point B. Okay, after that we will find out moment. We will find out moment. Find moment. So now you tell me how to find out moment. So this 5 kN creates clockwise movement towards A point. Okay, so m which is equal to 5 × 0.5, because of this is the perpendicular distance. So therefore m which is equal to 5 × 0.5 is 2.5. I have done here mistake. So we have to take moment about pulley. We have to take moment at pulley. So our pulley is here. So moment, we have to take moment here. So this RA creates clockwise movement to this pulley. So the value of RA is 2.5 × 0.5. So 2.5 × 0.5 is, I think, 1.5 kN. So this is the movement. Okay. After that, next we have to find out torque, because of for finding out diameter we require movement and torque. So in this problem, movement and torque is not given. So moment already we have calculated. Now we will find out torque. Find torque T. So for finding out this torque, power and revolutions per minutes are given. Okay, power and revolutions per minute are given. So power equation P, which is equal to 2 pi n t divided by 60. 2 pi n t divided by 60. So here P means power, T is torque, and this n is number of revolutions per minute. Okay, so this is 60. Whenever our value is given in minute, then you will take this 60. If this revolutions will be given in second, that is 300 RPS, at that time you don't take this 60. Okay, therefore now we will put value in this equation. So P, which is equal to P, value of P is given. Okay, value of P is given. So P is 500 kilowatt. So 500 × 10⁻³, which is equal to 2 × pi × number of revolutions, 300 × t/60. Now we will shift these all terms to left side, and only we will T, which is equal to this 500 × 10⁻³ × 60 divided by 2 × pi × 300. So calculate T and give me answer. T, which is equal to how much?
1.59 × 10³ Nm.
Okay, into 10³ Newton meter. So 1.59 × 10³. Okay, into 10³ Nm. So we will convert T, which is equal to 15.915 × 10⁶ Nm. Okay, 10⁶ Nm. So this is the torque. This is the torque. Now, moment and torque we got. So we will apply shear stress formula. Because of here, permissible shear stress is given. Okay, permissible shear stress is given. Then next step is find diameter by using tau max formula, tau max equation. Okay, tau max equation. So our tau max equation is tau max which is equal to 16 divided by pi d cube in bracket m square plus t square. Okay, so this m and t already we have calculated. So here m we will convert into newton mm. So m which is equal to for kilonewton 10 raised to 3 and for meter to mm 10 raised to 3, that is 1.25 into 10 raised to 6 newton mm. Okay, so now we will put values here. Tau max, the value of tau max is given and this is 50. So 50 which is equal to 16 divided by pi d cube, we will take as it is. Okay, here m is 1.25 into 10 raised to 6 square bracket square plus t, the value of t is 15.915 into 10 raised to 6 bracket square. So 10 raised to 6 we will take common, 10 raised to 6 we will take common, so you will easily find out. Okay
ma'am, to square root rahega,
square root rahe lena ma'am.
Ah, yes. So here in square root m square plus t square, here also square root is there. Okay, thank you. 1 and here square root is there. Okay, from that we will take 10 raised to 6 common. So we will shift d cube to left side and this 50 to this side. Okay, here I think 50 newton per mm square, right? So d cube which is equal to 16 into 10 raised to 6 divided by pi into 50 into in bracket square root of 1.25 square plus 15.915 square. Now you solve and give me the answer, d cube which is equal to how much and then d which is equal to how much.
D cube is 16.081 1056 2 6 0 8 2 2 2 1057 0 57,
and finally D which is equal to
117.60
Okay. So D which is equal to 117.60. Okay. So this is the final answer. Once again, I will repeat. Here, one circular shaft is given and one pulley is placed at the middle of the shaft. Okay. So total pull is 5 kilonewton. Okay. According to this, load taken by A point is half of the total load and load taken by B point is the half of the total load. So RA which is equal to 5/2 and RB which is equal to 5/2. After that, next you have to find out movement. So how to find out movement about the pulley? So we have to find out the movement about the pulley. So RA creates clockwise movement. So RA into perpendicular distance is 0.5. So M which is equal to 2.5 into 0.5. After that, next we have to find out torque. Okay, for finding out this torque, the value of power is given. So we will apply here power formula. So P which is equal to 2 pi NT divided by 60. Whenever this N number of revolutions given in terms of minute, then you divide by 60, and if number of revolutions is given in second at that time you don't take this 60. So here revolution per minute given, so I have divided by 60. So P, which is equal to 2 pi NT divided by 60. The value of power is 500 into 10 raised to 3, which is equal to 2 pi into N is 300 into T. Okay, after that, I have converted this equation in terms of T. So T, which is equal to 500 into 10 raised to 3 into 60 divided by 2 pi into 300. From this power equation, we have calculated torque. Once we got moment and torque, after that, we are able to find out diameter. So for finding out this diameter, permissible shear stress is given. So permissible shear stress formula is, or maximum shear stress formula, which is equal to 16 pi d cube in bracket square root of m square plus t square. Here tau max value is given. M already we have calculated, T already we have calculated, and we have to find out this diameter. So I have converted this equation in terms of diameter and putted values of M and T. After putting the values, we got D, which is equal to 117.60 mm. So this is the final answer. Please write down fast and let me know after your writing is over. So we will take next problem. Please write down fast. Over.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, write down next problem. As shown in the figure, as shown in the figure, force F is 0.55 kilonewton, axial thrust P which is equal to 8 kilonewton, and torque T which is equal to 30 newton meter. Torque T which is equal to 30 newton meter is applied on the circular shaft of 20 mm diameter. Okay, 20 mm diameter, full stop. Find principal stresses and direction of principal stresses, full stop. Also find maximum shear stress. Okay, so I will draw figure here, you can also draw, then we will solve problem. So this is the circular shaft is given. And the shaft is fixed at one end. Likewise, and here force F is applied. So this shaft is fixed here. Here force is applied F which is equal to 0.55 kilonewton. Then here axial force P is applied, and P is, I think, 8 kilonewton. Okay. The diameter of this shaft is given. So diameter of shaft is D which is equal to 20 mm, and the length of the shaft is L which is equal to 100 mm, and on that rod torque is applied. Okay, and the value of torque is 30 newton meter. So T which is equal to 30 newton meter. So this is the figure. First we will write given parameters and then we will solve problem. So first we will write given. So in given, which parameters are given? Diameter of shaft D which is equal to 20 mm. After that F which is equal to 0.55 kilonewton. Length which is equal to 100 mm, then axial force P which is equal to 8 kilonewton, and torque which is equal to 30 न्यूटन मीटर. ओके सो नाउ यू टेल मी विच पैरामीटर इज रिक्वायर्ड और रिमेनिंग फॉर प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस. विच पैरामीटर इज नॉट गिवन.
M.
So first,
yeah.
First we have to find out moment, then we will find principal stresses. Okay. So second step is find moment. Okay. Second step is find moment. Okay. For finding out this moment, I will draw here free body diagram. So suppose this is cantilever beam, and here F is applied 0.55 kilonewton. F is 0.55 kilonewton and this is distance is 100 m. So m which is equal to moment which is equal to, anyone tell me how to find out moment? Anyone? M which is equal to m which is equal to, this creates clockwise moment to this A point, so 0.55 into 100. So m which is equal to 0.55 into 100. Therefore, m which is equal to how much? 55 kilonewton mm. Because of length is in mm. So we will convert this kilonewton to newton. So m which is equal to 55 into 10 raised to 3. Newton mm. So this is the value of m. Okay. Now next we have to find out bending stress. We have to find out bending stress. Okay. Next step is find bending stress. Step three, find sigma b. So how to find out sigma b? Anyone tell me?
Yeah, divided by
sigma b which is equal to m into y by I. Okay, so for this circular shaft, first we will find out I. So moment of inertia for circular shaft which is equal to pi d raised to 4 divided by 64. Okay, so which is equal to pi into diameter is 20 raised to 4 divided by 64. So now you tell me I which is equal to how much?
78 54.98 78 54 4 4.98 98 mm raised to 4.
So this is the moment of inertia. After that, next we have to find out y, the location of stress. So location of stress y which is equal to diameter by 2, so which is equal to 20 by 2 which is equal to 10 mm. So y is 10 mm. Now here moment already we have calculated, y calculated and I. Therefore sigma b which is equal to m is m into y upon I. So sigma b which is equal to moment is 55 into 10 raised to 3 into 10 divided by I is 7854.98. Therefore, sigma b which is equal to how much?
70.04 newton per mm square.
70.04 newton per mm square. So this is the bending stress. Then we will find out shear stress or torque. Find shear stress. Shear stress. That is tau. Okay, already you know that equation is tau which is equal to TR divided by J. Torque is given. R we will calculate. Okay, so R which is equal to again D by 2 which is equal to 20 by 2 which is equal to 10 mm. Then next, J. J is the polar moment of inertia. So polar moment of inertia for circular rod is pi d raised to 4 divided by 32, which is equal to pi into 20 raised to 4 divided by 32. Therefore, J which is equal to how much?
One five seven zero seven point ninety.
15707.96 mm^4. So this is the polar moment of inertia. Now we will put all values in shear stress equation. All values in shear stress equation. So tau, which is equal to tau, which is equal to Pr divided by J. So tau, which is equal to T, torque is given 30 Newton meter. So 30 into 10 raised to 3 Newton mm into R is 10 divided by J. J is the polar moment of inertia, and the value of polar moment of inertia is 15707.96. So calculate shear stress and tell me tau, which is equal to how much? 19.09 newton per mm square. So this is the shear stress, and last stress is remaining. So normal stress due to axial force. Okay, normal stress due to thrust. So sigma A which is equal to force upon area. So which is equal to axial thrust is given. So 8 into 10 raised to 3 divided by area of circular shaft is pi by 4 into diameter square. So calculate stress and tell me therefore sigma A, which is equal to how much?
25.47 newton per mm square.
So this is the normal stress due to axial thrust, axial load or thrust. Okay, so now we have checked all effect: bending stress due to moment, shear stress due to torque, and normal stress due to thrust or axial load. Now we will take addition of this bending stress and normal stress. Therefore, sigma, which is equal to sigma B plus sigma A. Therefore, sigma, which is equal to sigma B is 70.04 plus sigma A is 25.47. Therefore, sigma, which is equal to how much?
95.51 newton per mm square.
So this is the sigma. And tau already we have calculated, tau, which is equal to 19.09. Now we are able to find out principal stress. So principal stress, which is equal to step number 6. Principal stress, which is equal to, so sigma 1, sigma 2, which is equal to our formula is sigma by 2 plus minus square root of sigma by 2 square plus tau square. Already tau calculated and sigma is calculated. So sigma 1 comma sigma 2, which is equal to sigma. The value of sigma is 95.51 divided by 2 plus minus square root of 95.51 by 2 bracket square plus tau is 19.09 square. So whenever you calculate sigma 1, you use this plus sign, and for finding out sigma 2, you use this minus sign. Therefore, sigma 1, which is equal to how much, and sigma 2, which is equal to how much?
19.17 newton per mm square,
and sigma 2, which is equal to
3.676
newton per mm square. So these are the मेजर एंड माइनर प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस, मेजर एंड माइनर प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस. आफ्टर दैट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट लोकेशन ऑफ प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेस, लोकेशन ऑफ प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेस. ओके, सो हाउ टू फाइंड आउट लोकेशन ऑफ प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेस, नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज स्टेप नंबर 7. सो स्टेप नंबर 7, फाइंड principal plane, principal plane. So how to find out principal plane? Tan 2 theta, which is equal to 2 tau divided by sigma. Therefore, tan 2 theta, which is equal to 2 into value of tau is 19.09 divided by value of sigma is 95.51. Therefore, theta, which is equal to tan inverse of 2 into 19.09 divided by 95.51 and whole divided by 2. So therefore theta, which is equal to how much?
10.90 degrees.
So this is the theta 1, and theta 2, which is equal to theta 1 plus 90, so which is equal to 10.90 plus 90. Therefore theta 2, which is equal to 100.90 degrees. So these are the principal planes, theta 1 and theta 2. Okay, after that, last question is remaining. That is, we have to find out maximum shear stress. Maximum shear stress. Okay, so step number 8, find maximum shear stress. Maximum shear stress. Find maximum shear stress. So here we have to apply tau max equation. So tau max, which is equal to
sigma 1 minus sigma 2 divided
sigma 1 minus sigma 2 divided by 2. So tau max, which is equal to sigma 1 is, I think, 99.17 minus sigma 2 is minus 3.67 divided by 2. Therefore, tau max, which is equal to how much? Yes, how much?
51.41
Newton per mm square. So this is the last answer. Got it? So whenever this type of problem comes, first you have to find out bending stress, shear stress, and then normal stress. After that, you have to take addition of bending stress and normal stress. And next is shear stress. Once you got normal or bending stress and then shear stress, you apply principal stress formula. And after that, find principal plane and maximum shear stress. Okay. So please write down fast. We will take one remaining last problem and conclude this unit number 3. Okay, one last problem is remaining. So I request all of you, please read on first. Okay, please write down next problem. This is the last problem of unit number 3. I will read problem, you write down, then we will solve. A horizontal bracket ABC, consists of two perpendicular arms, ARMS, two perpendicular arms, AB and BC, of 1.2 meter and 0.4 meter in length respectively. 1.2 meter and 0.4 meter in length respectively. Full stop. The arm AB has a solid circular cross section. The arm AB has a solid circular cross section. With diameter is 60 mm. Diameter is 60 mm. Full stop. At point C, load P1 which is equal to 2.02 kilonewton. Load P1 which is equal to 2.02 kilonewton acts vertically and a load P2 3.07 kilonewton acts horizontally and parallel to AB. Full stop. Find principal plane, and maximum shear stress. So I will draw figure simultaneously. You can also draw, then we will solve problem. So this is okay, so this is our horizontal bracket ABC. This is A, this is B, and this is C. Here one horizontal force is act P2, which is equal to 3.07 kilonewton. Horizontal force, and this horizontal force is parallel to ABR. Okay, and one vertical force is applied, and this P1 which is equal to 2.02 kilonewton. 2.02 kilonewton. So this distance is 0.4 meter, this distance, and this distance is 1.2 meter. Okay. So this vertical force creates movement as well as torque, and this horizontal or this axial force creates only thrust. Only thrust. So first we will find out, first we will find thrust. Find thrust, that is T. So T which is equal to, T which is equal to, how to find out thrust? T which is equal to, now this P1 creates torque. No, first we will calculate torque, not thrust. Find torque T. So T which is equal to P1 into perpendicular distance is 0.4 meter. Okay. So P1 into 0.4. So therefore T which is equal to 2.02 into 0.4. Therefore T which is equal to how much? 0.808 kilonewton meter. Okay, this, so this is the torque. After that, next we will find out moment. Find moment M. So M, this P1 creates movement. Okay, so M which is equal to P1 into, now this perpendicular distance is 1.2 meter, 1.2. So M which is equal to P1 is 2.02 into 1.2. Therefore moment which is equal to, I think 2.424 kilonewton meter. So this is the moment. Okay. Once we got T and M, now we are able to find out bending stress. Then next one is shear stress, and then we will find out normal stress. Okay, so next step is find bending stress. Find bending stress, bending stress, sigma b, bending stress, sigma b. Anyone please tell me how to find out bending stress? Sigma b which is equal to M into Y divided by I. Okay. So here M, M already we have calculated 2.424. We will convert into Newton mm. So into 10 raised to 6 into Y. Y means diameter is given. Okay. Diameter is given. So diameter is 60. So 60 by 2 divided by I, moment of inertia. So moment of inertia is pi by 64 into d raised to 4, that is 60 raised to 4. Therefore sigma b which is equal to how much? So you calculate and tell me sigma b which is equal to how much? Newton per mm square. This is correct or incorrect? Anyone please give me reply fast. Anyone?
Yes.
Okay. So sigma b which is equal to 114.30 Newton per mm square. After that, next we will find out shear stress. Find shear stress. Shear stress, and shear stress is nothing but tau. So how to find out shear stress? Tau which is equal to T into R divided by J. So which is equal to T, torque already we have calculated 0.808 into, again you have to convert into Newton mm, so 10 raised to 6 into R means D by 2, that is 60 by 2. and divided by J is polar moment of inertia and polar moment of inertia for circular shaft is pi by 32 into D raised to 4. So accordingly you calculate shear stress tau which is equal to how much and you answer tau which is equal to 19.05 is correct or incorrect? Please check. Tau which is equal to 19.05 newton per mm square.
Yes, ma'am. Correct.
Okay. So these two stresses are due to this vertical force. Now we will see what is the effect of this horizontal force. So this horizontal force is axial force, and due to this axial force, which type of stress will be generated?
Normal
stress. So find normal stress. Find normal stress, that is sigma A, which is equal to So sigma A, which is equal to force divided by area. So force is given, that is P2. So P2 is 3.07 into 10 raised to 3 divided by area of circular shaft is pi by 4 into diameter square, that is 60 square. Therefore, sigma A, which is equal to 1.085 newton per mm square. Please check this is correct or incorrect.
Yes, ma'am, 1.805.
Okay, after that, next sigma, which is equal to sigma B plus sigma A. So sigma, which is equal to sigma B is 114.30 plus sigma A is 1.085. Therefore, sigma, which is equal to 115.385 newton per mm square, and tau, which is equal to 19.05 newton per mm square. So we will find out principal stresses. Okay, so find principal stresses. Sigma 1 comma 2, which is equal to sigma 1 comma sigma 2 sigma by 2 plus minus square root of sigma by 2 square plus tau square. So sigma 1 comma sigma 2, which is equal to sigma is 115.385 divided by 2 plus minus square root of 115.385 by 2 square plus 19.05 square. So calculate and tell me sigma 1, which is equal to how much, and sigma 2, which is equal to how much. In sigma 1, which is equal to 118.44 newton per mm square, and sigma 2 is minus 3.06 newton per mm square. Please check answers. Sigma 1 is and sigma 2. Once we got sigma 1 and 2, next is we have to find out principal plane. And after that, maximum shear stress. Okay, principal plane and maximum shear stress. Okay, so next step is step number 7. Find principal plane. So how to find out principal plane? Principal plane, which is equal to tan 2 theta, which is equal to 2 tau divided by sigma. Okay. Therefore, theta, which is equal to tan inverse of 2 into 19.05 divided by 115.385 divided by 2. Therefore, theta, which is equal to. So this is theta 1, which is equal to. Then theta 2, which is equal to theta 1 plus 90.
Theta 1 is equal to 9.136.
Okay, 9.136 degree. And theta 2, which is equal to 9.136 degree plus 90. Therefore, theta 2, which is equal to 99.136 degree. So this is theta 1 and this is theta 2. Once you got theta 1 and 2, next step is you have to find out maximum shear stress. This is last step, step number 8. Maximum shear stress. Shear stress. So tau max which is equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 2 divided by 2. Therefore, tau max, which is equal to sigma 1, is 118.44 minus 3.06 divided by 2. Therefore, final answer, tau max, which is equal to
119.97.
No, I think something is wrong. Please check once again. 118.44. This plus gets, sorry, minus gets plus 3.06 divided by 2. 60.75 is correct?
Yes, ma'am. 60.
60.75 newton per mm square. So this is the maximum shear stress. Okay. So this is our last answer. So likewise, you have to solve problems on combined bending, torsion and thrust. So whenever you have to solve this problem, first you have to find out bending stress, then shear stress, then next normal stress. After that, you have to take addition of bending stress and normal stress. And then you are able to find out principal stresses. Okay. So use equation of principal stress. After that, next, find principal plane. And last one is maximum shear stress. Okay. So, now our unit number 3 is over. In next lecture, we will start unit number 4. Okay. Please write down fast.